In Lesson 3, we will look at a high-level overview of participation in an Advanced Alternative Payment Model, or Advanced APM, for Year 2 of the Quality Payment Program. First, let's understand that in general, an APM is a payment approach developed in partnership with the clinician community that provides added incentives to clinicians to provide high-quality and cost-efficient care. APMs can apply to a specific clinical condition, a care episode, or a population. APMs may offer significant opportunities to eligible clinicians who are not immediately able or prepared to take on the additional risk and requirements of advanced APMs. Advanced Alternative Payment Models, or advanced APMs, are a subset of APMs and enable clinicians and practices to earn greater rewards for taking on some risk related to their patient outcomes. By participating in this path of the quality payment program, an opportunity for extra incentives is created. There is a 5% lump sum incentive for a sufficient degree of participation in advanced APMs. As mentioned in Lesson 1, three criteria must be met in order to be an advanced alternative payment model. First, participants must be required to use Certified Electronic Health Record Technology, or CERT. This means that at least 50% of the clinicians in each APM use CERT to document and communicate clinical care information with patients and other healthcare professionals. Second, the APM must base payments on quality measures that are comparable to those used in the MIPS quality performance category. Payments must be tied to quality measures that are evidence-based, reliable, and valid, and at least one of these measures must be an outcome measure if an appropriate outcome measure is available on the MIPS measure list. The third requirement is that the APM is either a medical home model expanded under CMS Innovation Center authority, or it requires participants to bear a more than nominal amount of financial risk. In order to achieve status as a qualifying APM participant, or QP, and qualify for the 5% APM incentive payment for Year 2, eligible clinicians must receive a certain percentage of payments for covered professional services or see a certain percentage of patients through an advanced APM during the 2018 performance period. For payment years 2019 through 2024, clinicians who meet the QP requirements are excluded from MIPS adjustments and receive a 5% lump sum incentive payment for their Part B professional services furnished during the calendar year immediately prior to the payment year. Qualifying APM participants will also receive a higher physician fee schedule update starting in 2026. Let's look at some of the 2018 advanced APMs. The Comprehensive End-Stage Renal Disease Care Model, the Comprehensive Primary Care Plus, CPC Plus Model, Tracks 2 and 3 of the Medicare Shared Savings Program, the Next Generation Accountable Care Organization, ACO, Model, and the Oncology Care Model with Two-Sided Risk Arrangement were all advanced APMs for transition year 2017. Note that the Medicare Shared Savings Program Track 1 model is not currently considered an advanced APM and therefore not eligible for the 5% bonus. However, the newly introduced MSSP Track 1 Plus model is considered an advanced APM for 2018. Clinicians are encouraged to check back with CMS periodically on the Quality Payment Program website to stay up to date on the most accurate list of advanced APMs for 2018. Next, let's look at a few variables that apply to advanced APMs for Year 2 of 2018. For the 2017 transition year, there were two ways that APMs can meet the nominal amount standard, which govern whether an APM imposes at least a nominal amount of financial risk on clinicians. APMs can meet the standard if the total potential risk under the APM was at least 8% of the average estimated Parts A and B revenue of providers and suppliers in participating APM entities. The same is true for Year 2 in 2018 and will extend to performance periods of 2019 and 2020 as well. Another way to meet the nominal amount standard is if the total potential risk under the APM is equal to or at least either 3% of the expected expenditures an APM entity is responsible for under the terms of the APM. This expected expenditure standard or benchmark-based standard is applicable to all performance years. In addition to the general nominal risk standard, CMS also finalized a separate definition of a medical home model that only applies to the quality payment program along with the special financial risk criterion. Per this definition, medical home models that are APMs start with a pair arrangement where the participants are focused on primary care. Participants may also be multi-specialty practices that include primary care physicians and practitioners and other primary care services. They empanel patients to primary clinicians and require a patient-clinician link. There are also 7 model design options that the model can incorporate, of which at least 4 must be met. They include planned coordination of chronic and preventive care, patient access and continuity of care, risk stratified care management, coordination of care across the medical neighborhood, patient and caregiver engagement, shared decision making, and payment arrangements in addition to or substituting for fee-for-service payments. Medical home models are subject to different and more flexible standards in order to meet the financial risk criterion to become an advanced APM. Previous rulemaking stated that beginning in performance year 2018 and thereafter, the medical home financial risk standard would only apply to the APM entities and advanced APMs with fewer than 50 clinicians in their parent organization. The same standard applies for year 2 of the quality payment program, with a limited exception. Specifically, 2017 participants in Round 1 of the Comprehensive Primary Care Plus model, or CPC Plus, are exempted from the requirement that the medical home model financial risk standard applies only to APM entities with fewer than 50 clinicians in their parent organization. However, all future participants in CPC Plus, including 2018 starters, will be subject to the 50 clinician cap policy. There is also one change to the medical home model nominal amounts standard for year 2 of the quality payment program. In the 2017 rule, CMS finalized that the total potential risk for an APM entity must be equal to or at least 3% in 2018, and then gradually increased to 5% in 2020 and thereafter. The nominal amounts are changed so that the minimum required amount of total risk increases more gradually. Therefore, the standard of 2.5% will apply in 2018, and then increase to 5% in 2021 and thereafter. CMS believes this approach may allow for greater flexibility and encourage more participation in medical home models.